Hello children, again in this class we are going to discuss the topic, that is triangles. In the triangles, the concept I have chosen here, basic proportionality theorem. Let us prove this theorem by taking this statement. Here statement is given: if a line is drawn parallel to one side of a triangle to intersect the other two sides in distinct points, the other two sides are divided in the same ratio. Other two sides are divided in the same ratio. Before going to prove this theorem, students, here let us understand the preconcepts. What are the preconcepts? What is the formula to calculate area of a triangle? And when we draw altitude for a triangle, whether it lies inside the triangle, outside the triangle, or it lies on this side. And next concept is that triangles having the same base and between the same parallels. What is the property behind in that way? Let us see one by one. The formula to calculate area of triangle is equals to half into base into height. We must know this one to prove the BPT theorem. And the second concept we must know here: when we draw altitude for a triangle, whether it is acute angle triangle, right angle triangle, or it is obtuse angle triangle. For all these triangles, if we draw the altitude, whether it lies inside the triangle, for this triangle, it always lies inside the triangle. It always lies inside the triangle. For right angle triangle, it always lies on this side. AB itself is the altitude. For this triangle, obtuse angle triangle, here the altitude comes outside the triangle. If we extend this ABC, it always lies outside the triangle. This is the second thing we must know. The third thing is the triangles having the same base and between the same parallels. Here D is parallel to BC. D is parallel to BC. Here I have taken two triangles. One is BDE triangle. Another one is BEC triangle. Both these two triangles are having the same base DE and they are having the same parallels DE and BC. And such a type of triangles are the geometrical figures which are having the same base and between the same parallels, they are always having the equal area. Therefore, area of triangle BDE is equal to the area of triangle BEC. This is the concept we must know when we are going to prove the theorem. So, let us prove this theorem by using this statement. These are the basic things we must know when we are going to prove the theorem. Okay, children, let us prove this one. Here, our statement always tells us certain things. It gives the data and it gives what we need to prove. Here, according to statement, we have to draw the diagram. Let us draw the diagram for this one. As this statement tells us, if a line is drawn parallel to one side of a triangle, it means we require a triangle here. We require one triangle. Let us take one triangle. Let us take a triangle ABC. And draw the triangle here. A, B, C is a triangle. In this triangle, we have to draw a line parallel to any one side. Here I will draw a line parallel to BC. How we have to draw this line parallel to BC? When we draw this line parallel to BC, here D is parallel to BC. And this D line is intersecting the other two sides, AB at D and BC at E. After doing this, let us write the what is the data given here. The data given here, triangle ABC is given. In that one, D is parallel to BC. D is parallel to BC. And what we need to prove according to the statement, we need to prove the other two sides. What are the other two sides? One is AB, another one is AC. For third side, we have drawn the line parallel. So, to prove, what we need to do here? AD divided by DB is equals to AE divided by EC. AE divided by EC. This is what we need to prove. To prove this one, dear children, we need a small construction here. As I told you in the previous, here we have to draw the altitude for the triangle ADE by using the vertex E. If I draw the altitude for this one, here this is the altitude. Let us name this one as EN. And by using the, again, we have to draw using the vertex B to base A. If I draw another vertex altitude, that is DM. DM is the another altitude drawn by the vertex B to the side A. And here ABE is an acute angle triangle. So our altitude always lies inside the triangle. This is the construction what we need. And then we have to join B to C and B to E. We have to join these two children. So what we have constructed here? Construction. Construction. Drawn altitude or drawn EN perpendicular to AD and DM perpendicular to AE. This is what we have drawn and join B to C and B to E. This is what we have joined. Okay, now let us prove this one. What we have to prove? AD by DB is equal to AE by EC. This is what we have to prove. Let us prove this one, children. Proof. Here, I am going to prove this theorem. First, consider this side AB. In this one, let us consider the triangle ADE triangle. In this one, so area of the triangle ADE is equals to half into base into height. So this is equals to half into base is what here? AD is the base. AD is the base. So AD into its altitude is what? EN is its altitude. EN is the altitude. This is the first equation what we require. Next triangle. Let us consider the next triangle here. BDE triangle. This is related to side AD. So let us take the triangle BDE. So area of triangle BDE is equals to half into here. What is its base in triangle BDE? Base is BD into its height. So observe here. This is an obtuse angle triangle. So its altitude lies outside the triangle. So EN is the altitude. EN. So, similarly here, let us take the ratio between these two students. If we take the ratio between these two equations, let us consider this one as equation number 1 and this one as equation number 2. If I take the ratio between these two, that is, area of triangle ADE divided by area of triangle BDE is equal to, area of triangle AD is what? Half into base is AD into its height is EN. 4 divided by area of triangle BDE, half into BDE into EN. So here half get cancels. EN get cancels. So this is equal to students. AD divided by BD. Let us consider this one as equation number 3. Equation number 3. Similarly, now let us consider this side AC. By considering the side AC, again we can calculate the triangle area of triangle ADB by taking A as the base and BM as the altitude. So therefore, area of triangle ADE is equals to half into, here what we have chosen the base, A is the base. A is base and what is its altitude? BM is its altitude. BM is its altitude. Let us take this one as equation number 4. Equation number 4. So next triangle, what we have to choose here according to side AC, that is DEC triangle. We have to take the triangle DEC. So this implies area of triangle DEC is equal to half into, what is base here? EC is the base. CE is the base, EC is base, and into its altitude. What is its altitude? Its altitude is BM. Its altitude is BM. So, this is equation number 5. It is equation number 5. So, let us divide equation number 4 and 5. Again, we have to divide these two equations. So, by dividing the area of triangle ADE, four divided by area of triangle BEC is equal to half into this is BE into BM, four divided by half into EC into BM. Again, children, here 1/2, 1/2 get cancels. DM get cancels. So this is equals to AE divided by EC. This is equation number 6. It is equation number 6. So here, now we can consider the equation number 3 and 6. Let us take ratio between equation number 3 and 6. If we take ratio between these two, here I will take ratio between those two. Here, that is area of triangle ADE divided by area of triangle BDE is equal to AD divided by BD, 4 divided by area of triangle ADE divided by area of triangle BEC is equal to AE divided by EC. AE divided by EC. This is a very important thing here, children. That is, the triangles having same base. Here, triangle BDE is having base DE and triangle DEC is having base D. So these two are the triangles. It is the first triangle and it is the second triangle. Both are having the same base D and they are between the same parallels. So these two are having this equal area. DD and DEC are having same area and AD is equal to AD. So AD is equal to AD, it cancels. So this becomes equal to 1. It becomes equal to 1. So this implies 1 is equal to AD divided by BD, 4 divided by AD divided by EC. Cross multiply this one. Then if we cross multiply this one, that is why what we are doing, that is AD divided by EC is equal to AD divided by BD. Hence the proof, children. This is what we need to prove and what we have proved by using the statement. Thank you.